I decided to come to Vista Grande because, well, my parents had asked me to because my brother attended Vista and he graduated. And they really liked the school, but I was planning on attending the high school, but I came to check out their open house for the freshmen and new students. And I kind of just fell in love with the entire environment and the community and how it was like more of a family than it was a school. And I really liked that.
You know, I decided to come to the school just because the learning, ways of learning, also like the way it was a small school. You know, it's also different from all the other public schools.
Okay.
It was for the social atmosphere of it all, mostly.
Expand.
Like with the teachers, if the student needs help, they will put more time into that one student than going around helping everyone else and not paying attention to the person that need help.
I came to Vista Grande because the small environment of Taos High School was basically too crowded, too much students, a lot of textbooks, homework, and I really enjoy the hands-on and the teachers and staff.
What I've enjoyed so far about being here is the trips we've gone on, that the work is a little easier than I heard than in high school.
Expand.
And the teachers are nicer, they care. Like, the teachers seem like they care more than the high school people do. They show more, like, stuff to kids. What else is, like, it's small. It's a small school. There's not a lot of people in here.
The teachers, honestly, they're nice, and they're a lot more accepting than others have ever been. So when I get one-on-one or I have a situation or a problem, they actually help. So that just makes it.
I don't really think I dislike anything, probably just the principal.
Some of the teachers are kind of like a little bit lost. They kind of lose a lot of work, and I mean, sometimes the small environment is kind of like too much because people get really crowded and annoyed with one another and can't really like separate themselves. So.
It's like about this school would have to be how Vista Grande has lost its feeling, I guess. When I first came here, I felt comfortable, I felt at home. It was my second home, honestly. It was where I could go and I could talk to teachers and I could talk to friends. But now it's more like the teachers, they don't know how to deal with students now. It's something happens with the student and they send them to ISS. They don't talk to them. They try, but they end up doing I don't know what. And so they end up just sending them to ISS. And that, I feel like, isn't right. So it doesn't have that family thing to it, which is horrible because that's what Vista Grande was all about. That's why people loved it so much, and that's gone, and it's really sad.
You know, probably just kind of looking forward to college, probably working, stuff like that.
Learning? Because in this year, first year that I've been here, I have learned more in this one year than I've ever learned in my whole life, so.
What kind of things have you learned about?
Math, science, just.
Explain, expand. Like, what kind of sciences? What kind of math?
Like, plant growth, I've never known anything about that. Location, I was horrible with that. English, I can never write anything. I learned how to write things the real way. And just...
Besides graduation, I would have to say coming back here, seeing all the other people that I do know here already. Then on top of that, seeing the new people that show up, seeing if I could impart some of the knowledge of the short time, even if it is a short time that I was here, impart some of the knowledge that I have unto them.
All right, good job.
What I'm looking forward to is actually probably getting a part-time job, maybe like working at Rocky Mountain or some school or something. I'm pretty sure that there should be more people to Vista because I mean, it's a really good school, it's a charter school, but also, you know, like I said, without our own unique like people and things that we do as well as so many other people, and I think that's what I mean, things like more working, helping the school, trying to keep it open and trying to keep more people coming.
Just depending where you're coming from, all I gotta say is stay on top of your work, don't fall behind, I mean, school, it's gonna be difficult anywhere, make sure it's a paycheck, definitely, hard is really gonna start meaning something, good luck.
Just stay focused in school, don't slack. Don't say, oh, well, I'm just a freshman, I'm not going to graduate for another 3-4 years, so I don't have to worry about schoolwork. Yeah, you're going to have to worry about it, because in upcoming years, you're probably going to have to take each one of your classes. I didn't have to take any either, and I'm, like, I look at other people who are taking the 2020 classes, and they're so stressed.
Like Jordan.
They don't know if they're going to graduate, and that's really scary. And so just focus on work, and don't pay attention to your friends. Like, friends are going to be there for you all of your life. You're going to lose friends. That's what high school is, and you may find the real ones, which is great, but friends aren't always going to be there for you, so don't put all your attention into your friends, focus on yourself, because that's the important
thing. Okay, and I think...
Keep up with the work, just keep up with your work, just stay focused on what you're doing, and don't get distracted by it.
Okay.
Pretty good years.
I am so scared. That's my entire high school experience.
All right, good job.